everyone, and welcome to On the Fly. I'm Erica Wachter. Mike Kelly will be joining us in just a bit. We've got an action-packed hour with a 12-game slate that includes the Golden Knights looking to build off their best start in franchise history as they go for a fifth straight win to open up the season. And in Anaheim, this year's number two draft pick, Leo Carlson, makes his National Hockey League debut for the Ducks. But we begin with the first overall pick as Connor Bedard and the Blackhawks wrap up their season-opening road trip against the 3-0 Avs. Let's head straight to Denver now for the highlights.
But the Avs able to jump on it with Jack Johnson and their third pair on the Colorado blue line. Here's an opportunity breaking in as Nick Foligno in backhand. And Georgiev, a great save.
Foligno gets into the middle seam. Dickinson just swats the puck.
I will watch for the power play. You mentioned 1-for-18 for Chicago. Colorado looking to break. Here's the opportunity. Shorthanded score.
Avs most aggressive penalty killing group. Good play on the boards by Josh Manson. O'Connor's not going to be caught. He gets a beautiful shot. It's 1-0 Avs.
He goes cross ice. Seven in front. Unbelievable save by Mrazek. Loose puck, still loose. And now it's in.
Johansson's going to follow this puck back. This is his first goal as a Colorado Avalanche. Ryan Johansson's got a power play goal and a 2-0 lead. Setting the stage for Luke Richardson and the rebuild that was going to go on. A real positive presence around him.
Turned over in front. Mrazek is there again. Left all alone is Peter Mrazek.
It becomes a real game if the Hawks get the next one.
There for Drouin. Center in front. They score. What a pass from Jonathan Drouin.
Confirm the play was offside. No goal. Please reset the clock to 10:42.
Well, it's been a dominant effort by Colorado. Unbelievable wide open net for Devon Toews. Tic-tac-toe. What a beauty.
Johnson doesn't get it out, and Toews will make the pass and stay down low. Mrazek has no idea where the puck is at this point. It's 3-0.
And across the lines on his backhand and a forehand. Quick hands.
Two really strong rushes for Athanasiou in this third period. He gets a rush and beats Devon Toews to the outside. Airmails this over the top of the net.
McKinnon sniffing for one. There's a chance shot and he scores. Right on, Ray.
Lays it out there and Nate McKinnon's not going to miss from there. Last year led the NHL in 5-on-5 points.
Five last season. The other eight coming as a member of the New York Rangers. That shot, traffic. Georgiev put the glove out, and the Avs a thumping in their home opener.
Devon Toews has been playing stellar 5-on-5 hockey for a while now, and his goal in Thursday's win was his 115th even strength point since joining the Avalanche before the 2020-21 season. In that span, Toews is behind only Erik Karlsson for the most even strength points among all defensemen. And we bring in now Mike Kelly to chat about this one. I think a dominant effort, of course, by the Colorado Avalanche, something that we've grown accustomed to seeing. I think a real clear difference from the team across them that's certainly in that rebuild.
Absolutely. Look, this game had that real future meets the present vibe to it, right? With Bedard and McKinnon, but with the Blackhawks and the Avalanche as well. And it was very clear in this game that that's what it was. You got to remember Chicago also, not only in the rebuild, they're in day 10 of a 5-game road trip to start the season. They didn't have their legs as a team. The Avalanche are the better team. We know that. And Chicago just needs to go home at this point. Go home, unpack, and play a home game. So it had the makings of that coming into it. We certainly saw the Avalanche completely dominated the game. They skated circles around Chicago for huge parts of it. Like, goals like this are just, there's nothing Mrazek can do. And Mrazek was unbelievable in this game, trying to keep it respectable at the very least. So not a ton I would take from it if you're on the Chicago side of it, other than, you know, go home, get that first home game in on Saturday night. As for the Avalanche, they just keep rolling. This team is on fire to start the season.
Yeah, absolutely. Move to 4-0-0. Let's just talk quickly, though. We've got to do it about Connor Bedard. And you mentioned there, you know, he is the future of this league, and he's been ripping off shots left and right in this first few games. But tonight, held off the board, zero shots on goal. What did you make of his play? Because we know it's a tough place to play.
100%. Tough place to play, tough team to play against. And also, the kid's first five games in the NHL, 10 days on the road, like we just talked about. Mm-hmm. He was just like the rest of his team, where he didn't have his legs in this game. You know, every time he got the puck, it seemed there was one or two guys closing on him. Against a team like Colorado, not only do they skate fast, they play fast. There's less time and space to make plays. I felt like Bedard really felt that pinch in this game, whereas whenever he got the puck, there was just bodies on him, and he did not have a lot of room to operate. Like, gets it here, closed off into the boards. That's what the night kind of felt like overall for Bedard. Coming into the game, he was averaging 21 and a half minutes almost, right around that area, and he was almost at 20 minutes in this game. This kid's got to be a little fatigued at this point, so we've seen how dominant he can be. Coming into the game, he's top five in the league in shot attempts, scoring chances, rush chances. Brilliant, right? You look at the offensive zone puck possession as it's gone from his first game where he was over a minute, then just under, and then almost 2 minutes, but a little bit down and under 30 seconds for the first time in his young NHL career in this game. So just didn't have the legs. Neither did the rest of the team. He'll go home. He'll get refreshed, recharge in front of that crazy crowd in Chicago. And I think we'll see more of the Bedard that we saw in the first couple games on Saturday night than the one we saw here.
Yeah, I think he's certainly going to be feeling rejuvenated when he makes that home debut in front of those fans. Kels, don't go anywhere because we've got another big highlight we're going to chat about next. Let's get you some Golden Knights and the Jets.
Now Niederreiter at center. Martinez broke his stick. Here's Josh Morrissey over the line. Head up, shoots a rebound. Score! Iafallo with his second of the year.
That's going to enter the zone, and this is excellent. He looks to see if that wide lane is occupied. It is.
So the first power play of the game goes to the Golden Knights. Theodore thought about letting that fly. Moves it instead to Stevenson. Now Marchessault scores! Jonathan Marchessault with a blast. Stick side of Brossois. It's a power play goal to tie the game.
Well executed. What a shot for Jonathan Marchessault. He has his second of the season.
Perfetti across, Dylan has room, shot, Zane Thompson, rebound, and what a stop on Perfetti. Thompson went back across to his left.
Extends the pad, the stick, and it hits his stick. Early candidate for the save of the year right there.
What a save by Logan Thompson. And the puck back to Dylan DeMello. Stone with a steal, has Howden in front, and he scores! Stone with the steal, Howden with the deflection, and the Golden Knights with the lead.
Well, Bruce Cassidy, he get moved up. Howden rewards the coach. Quick two-on-one, and what a pass. As Stone outweights the slide by Morrissey.
Got it, runs it in deep. Carlson rolls, feeds it. Martinez with a chance, scores! Alec Martinez in his season debut. Rips it home, and the Golden Knights lead 3-1.
What a shot by Martinez. Perfectly places this bar down.
Ehlers will take it into the zone. Nikolai Ehlers for Domestikov. Perfetti scores! There it is. Cole Perfetti is first. And it's a one-goal game.
Outstanding execution. Ehlers to Domestikov and a little tap pass to Perfetti, who goes forehand, backhand, and he tucks it to get the game back within a goal.
The Jets have a chance to tie the game. Barbashev is in the box. Morrissey gives it to Nikolai Ehlers. Chesley set up. Iafallo scores! Well, that's the way you draw it up. Iafallo with his second of the night has tied the game at three.
It's the first power play goal the Vegas Golden Knights have given up all season.
Alex Iafallo, two goals tonight, but in the box right now. Stone looking. Eichel with a chance, and it scores! Jack Eichel with 4:36 left on the power play, and the Golden Knights lead 4-3.
Stone over to Eichel, and how about that shot short side upstairs as Eichel gives the Golden Knights the lead.
There goes Brossois to the bench. Lead pass to Juan with an open net in front of him. Juan looking, scores! From center ice, Nick Juan into the empty net with 1:03 left. Golden Knights a 5-3 win in Winnipeg, and they become the third defending champ to begin the new season 5-0.
Well, so much for that Stanley Cup hangover. The Golden Knights have picked up right where they left off, winning each of their first five games to start the season. Vegas is just the third reigning Cup champion to begin the season with five straight wins, joining the 85-86 Oilers and 1920-21 Senators. And Kels, I know you've been so high on these defending champs in the early go of the season. What is it about this versatile group and the way they're able just to continue to get it done that is the most impressive? Because you can take a lot from this team.
Totally. What impresses me the most about them is they can beat you in so many different ways. You want to have a street fight with the Vegas Golden Knights, they'll do it and they'll win. You want to play an up and down rush game, they'll do it and they'll win. And in this game, they were so hungry on the forecheck, causing turnovers, forcing the Jets into making mistakes, stealing pucks from the Winnipeg Jets, winning board battles. A great board battle win here late in the second period. It's a one-goal game. And then just hungry on pucks. Win another battle right here. Maintain that offensive zone puck possession. Work it around till you find an open man. Pucks in the back of the net. All game long, it was either Vegas forcing Winnipeg into their own mistakes or just simply out-muscling them on pucks, winning battles on the boards again, whether it's on the power play, whether it's at even strength. They did an exceptional job of this. And this is just one way they can beat you. Like I said, they are the best, in my view, the best transition team in the league going from defense to offense up the ice. They've got great goaltending. However you want to play them, they'll play that way and they will probably win. That's why they won a cup last year. And that's why for me right now, they're the only 5-0 team. They're the favorite to win it again.
That's why the house is so hard to beat. You never bet against Vegas, Sarah. They are just continuing to show it. Well, we got to talk about the Jets though too, Mike, because after the game, head coach Rick Bowness, not too pleased about the number of turnovers from his club. He said, "We just can't keep giving up 4-5 goals a game. We're not going to win until we stop that," which means we've got to clean up our zone. Our turnovers in our zone are really costing us. And Mike, you've got the numbers to back up exactly what he's saying.
Yeah, they did. And like I said, part of this is Vegas. A lot of it is Vegas and what they do to teams. But the other part is Winnipeg. Vegas won over 60% of the puck battles. They had 11 scoring chances directly off of turnovers. Winnipeg, they have a good offense. They got good goaltending. Defense is the thing that's going to be the question mark with them this season.
Yeah, well, we know that Vegas team, they caused a lot of problems for a lot of teams, including the Panthers, back in the Stanley Cup Finals a season ago. And that's the highlight we're headed to next as they hosted the Leafs for their home opener.
Coming off that tough 4-1 home ice loss to Chicago, the Leafs now embark on their longest road trip of the year, a five-gamer starting against the team that knocked them out in the second round of the playoffs last year.
The place is electric tonight for this home opener against the Maple Leafs, and they're the Eastern Conference champions. There's a new banner in the house.
So 2 minutes and 20 seconds into the opening period, the Panthers get the game's first power play.
Moves it up the wall for Los Torino. He gets taken down. Finds Forsling, who finds Tkachuk. Matthew Tkachuk shoots save. Rebound Tkachuk again. Looking to jam it in. But Samsonov made the save.
Well, that's the best of his season. What a stop on Matthew Tkachuk. And Samsonov gets it out and gets it strong enough to fight off the charge of Tkachuk and keep it out of the net.
Lawrence joins the battle. Puck comes up the boards to Stenlin. He moves, he fires, he scores! First is a Panther! Stenlin makes it 1-0.
If you put the traffic in front of the net, sooner or later, one of those is going to squeeze through. Takes the eyes away from Samsonov, and that one just sails over top.
Final seconds. Barkov looking to give someone a chance. Ekman Larson shoots and scores! OEL! 2-0 Panthers with just seconds left in the period.
Tavares. Long shot tipped it, but rebound put wide by Riley, who jumped up.
He can't believe he missed it. Neither can I. Puck spinning, it does change the dynamic, but he was miles wide, and he cannot believe it.
Now Toronto to the power play for a minute and 28. Nylander, back to tomorrow's a hard job. Bobrovsky save, rebound, score! Mitch Marner, power play goal, and Toronto's back within one.
Bouncing puck, Verhaeghe gets to it. Verhaeghe stops, waits, looking for some help. He's got Kulikov, who takes a shot. It's off the inside of the post. Here we go with the net empty.
In behind the Florida goal, Nylander. Back for Marner, centers it all, what a chance for Tavares at the goal post. Bobrovsky's down, he's got it. Oh, what a chance at the side of the goal for John Tavares.
That's just positioning by the veteran goaltender in Bobrovsky.
Reinhardt wins the faceoff, but we get a whistle. And we're going to get a penalty, a tripping call, my goodness.
And now a chance for a 6-on-4 power play.
Klingberg goes across. Nylander shoots. That's blocked by Mikkola. He goes down. Tavares out in front of the net. It's Matthews centering for Klingberg. Another block. That was Steglin. What an effort by the Panthers. Final seconds. And the Florida Panthers blocking shots. Grind it out. And the empty netter for Reinhart. And the Rats fly in the home opener.
Beecher rotating. Marchand closes. Score! Several heads-up plays on that sequence.
Yeah, and again, the Bruins defense active in the offensive zone. Shattenkirk up in the play. Fulbert up in the play. But this is vintage Marchand right here. He takes that little short pass, gets it off his left hip, and he's got a rocket of a shot, and he just snaps it from about just outside the dot.
Frederick jams away, and the Bruins have their sticks in the air. They've scored two goals in 21 seconds.
Spin. Frederick's open. His stick's available. A pretty good start. 2-0 on the road after one. I like their chance.
Pastrnak with Marchand. Pastrnak! And the puck is in the goal! What a bizarre goal! Pastrnak was hit from behind and lost control of the puck. And it went off a skate blade and in.
It looked like the Sharks had it sorted out, but they didn't. David Pastrnak makes it 3-0.
Boyle jammed off Sturm. Zetterlund to Smith, and Omark makes the stop, and the rebound is wide.
Now a lead pass for Anthony Duclair. Duclair to the net, and he scores! Anthony Duclair with his first goal as a Shark.
Really nice play in the zone. Good work, good support. Tomas Hertl supports the play. Beautiful touch pass. And Anthony Duclair sticks with it. He puts it past Linus Ullmark.
And Beecher will run out the clock. Linus Ullmark is 5-0 lifetime against San Jose. The Bruins have won their 12th consecutive game against the Sharks.
After the break, Cam Atkinson shows off his silky smooth mitts against the Oil, while the Kings are already getting an early season ROI on PLD. Don't go anywhere. OTF rolls on next.
Tonight, Andre Kopitar ties a franchise record. He plays in game number 1,296. And those that have been following Minnesota first week and a half of the season say this has been, night after night, their best line. Here's Grundstrom a chance, and he scores!
Fleury does not keep it in a situation where the Wild can get the puck going. Fleury will say he has to have that one.
And here's your 1-3 through the neutral zone. Let's see if the Wild can work their way through the maze, get the puck up on the glass.
And they score!
Hartman has it back. Off the wall for Zuccarello. Into the middle, a drive by Marine, and they score!
Tipped by Kaprizov, and it's 2-1 Minnesota.
And off the draw, tipped to Kempe, a shot through traffic, block, loose, score!
Look at Kempe, he's out at the blue line, and guess who's in front? Kopitar, Byfield, and Gavrikov. And Byfield has a factor here because he creates the final screen. Because the goaltender cannot see the puck, it goes low, it goes in, and we're tied at two.
Picked up by Fiala, who clears it up the right wing boards, a foot race. After it, Dubois to the net, Dubois scores! P.L. Dubois! With just under a minute to play, that's goals in two straight for the newest King, and the Kings are up 3-2.
Well, a pretty eventful first period coming to a close. Turnover, Dubois shoots and scores!
Tipped into the middle of the ice, Dubois with another goal. 4-2 LA.
Now to Kaprizov for Zuccarello. Base of the left circle to the net. Cross-ice feed for Erickson. Didn't connect.
That's outstanding stick position. Perfect by the Kings defenseman.
Block. Kaprizov gets it back. Is tied up by Dubois. Kaprizov battling here, still with it. Sends it in front. A chance for Odin. Save Talbot.
knees across, at least he's square. He gets square before the shot of Brodin, and the Kings able to hold on.
Yeah, normally they blow that type of play down.
Galiev leaving it in front, and a chance, and a goal! Trevor Moore!
Loose puck, Johansson has it, and he scores!
Erickson Ek with his first 5-on-5 goal of the season.
For Zuccarello, feeds it behind the net. It's in front on a deflection, but Erickson Ek couldn't tee it up. Empty net shot and a goal. Kaprizov, a great look. Maybe his best of the night. And now an empty net shot. Score! So the Kings 2-for-2 on this quick road trip with a 7-3 win.
The Kings get a dominant 7-3 win over the Wild on Thursday. 13 different LA skaters registered at least 1 point in the victory, including Pierre-Luc Dubois, who found the back of the net twice, giving him 3 goals in his first 4 games with his new team. Kels, you love when that works out and someone fits right in with their new group. Those weren't just 2 goals. 2 goals in a 12-second span. Can you speak to the impact that he's bringing for this Kings club?
Yeah, 100%. The impact that he's bringing, Erica, it's not just what he's doing, which, as you just mentioned, is a lot. It's the effect that it has on the team as a whole and how it benefits other players that he doesn't even play with. And I'll explain that in a second. But this was the turning point in the game. It's a 2-2 hockey game, and PLD rips off 2 goals in a span of 12 seconds, like you said, and the LA Kings never look back. So that's the impact that he had on the game directly in terms of tilting this thing in LA's favor. The indirect impact that he has is it allows other lines to get softer matchups. And I'm talking about the Deneau line mainly, where they're now the third line. And you look at the 5-on-5 scoring by line this season, you know, Dubois kind of sawed off, and so is Kopitar in the top six. That Deneau line has been able to feast. They had 3 goals a couple of games ago. They had 1 goal in this game. And it's making life a little bit easier for them. So the effect that he has on the second line is evident in what he's been doing on the ice, but it also allows the other guys to have a little bit more space and contribute, and it makes the team that much better as a result.
Yeah, that goes a real long way. Great breakdown there. Let's get back to some of the highlights, though, now, and check out Edmonton and Philly.
Seeler tracking down. Quick dish in front, and McLeod just got it on the heel of his stick.
He thinks he can make a play. No, too many bodies in the middle, so he makes the right one down to Brown, and that's almost a tap-in backdoor for Ryan McLeod.
Cam York into the glove of Campbell. Nifty move by number 8 with the new number, the 22-year-old. And chip it up towards Fogle. Nice play by Sanheim, though, to get it right to Farabee, and back on the Flyers. Watch out for Farabee to break. What a play by Bobby Brink. The extra pass gives Joel Farabee a yawning net, and the Flyers, rewarded with their good effort so far, lead 1-0.
It was a step by Sanheim in the neutral zone that stopped the transition game for the Oilers coming down, and that allowed them to come right back in.
Here comes Tippett now. Tippett's got Atkinson in front. Go to him! Score! Cam Atkinson off a beautiful backhand feed from Owen Tippett, and the Fly Guys are up 2-0.
The neutral zone has been a place for turnovers that the Flyers have taken advantage of.
Often a successful kill can swing the game back the other way. McDavid sees it in front. Backhander score, and Zach Hyman puts Edmonton right back in this game. It's 2-1.
The absolute perfect time for a penalty kill like that for Edmonton. They just shut it down, didn't give the Flyers anything.
It's a miscue for the Flyers, and now they've got to see what they can do against this high-flying power play.
And here they come, short-handed. Shot, score! Sean Walker's first of the year, short-handed. The defenseman has given the Flyers their 2-goal lead back.
Just 16 shots for the Flyers, but they got the 3 goals, and they lead by 2.
Atkinson in alone! A spicy dangle from Cam Atkinson. His second goal of the game, his third of the year, and the Flyers lead 4-1. They take care of business against the Edmonton Oilers at home. Home opener was Tuesday. Second one, also a win.
Brown with a burst of speed. Paul trying to wrap it around and hangs on. Penalty call coming up again against the Canucks. Here's a shot in towards the net. Kucherov just couldn't finish. But it is a slashing call against the Canucks. And it will be a lightning power play. Here's a loose puck again. Give it up to Paul. Side of that. Oh, what a save. Another shot. And Demko got that to rebound. They score. They kept coming. And Steven Stamko scores on the power play to make it 1-0 Lightning.
There are rebounds. Thatcher Demko is all over the place. Looked like two goalies in the net there for a second. Demko was simply outstanding, but that was a beautiful read and steal there by Nick Hall.
Stolen behind the goal. Thrown in front. Besser scores. Just like that, Dave drew it up. 14 seconds into the second. The Canucks have tied the game and won.
Well, the coaching staff's going to run this clip where they need to get their team back to task. And Besser with the finish. But this is a play off the faceoff circle where Miller deflects it in. There's a double forecheck.
Patterson off the bench, keeps the puck in. Finds Myers with the room. Tyler Myers shoots, he scores! It's two goals for the Canucks in the first 62 seconds of the period, and Vancouver's on top by one.
Patterson keeps the play alive. Myers comes in, and as Radish is trying to block the shot, Myers is able to muscle this pass the blocker side.
Ciampa has tied the game at two.
Here's Kucherov again. Kucherov dances, the shoot!
Accuracy by Kucherov, but it's the screen in front by Cirelli that make it. Demko never even moved. Watch 71 will set up in front of the goaltender, and Kucherov will wave his magic wand right here.
Penalty call coming up here.
Watch Hagel get tweaked up here just as he's going to the net. That's a definite hook there by Ian Cole.
Paul wins the puck battle, steps out, hangs on. Kucherov scores!
Good power play in this game. They've had a lot of good looks. They really got Vancouver running around and tired. Nick Paul caused the commotion along the wall, made the play, was patient, get it to Kucherov, and Kucherov was not going to miss there.
Hughes out in front, blocked, cleared, and that is it. The Lightning hang on for the win.
The Canucks make a game of it late, but can't get the equalizer.
4-3.
Well, the early part of the NHL season has been Bedard mania. Now it's time for the second overall pick to take center stage. Leo Carlson's Ducks debut is coming up next right here on the fly.
Kucherov scores! Second goal of the game for Nikita Kucherov. That is the third multi-point game of the season for Kucherov.
What a stop on Perfetti. Jack Eichel with 4:36 left on the power play. And the Golden Knights lead 4-3.
The third defending champ to begin the new season 5-0.
Kicks it in the bar. Scott! Oh, that's a spicy dangle from Cam Atkinson. His second goal of the game.
Ekman Larson shoots and scores!
The Leafs a bit, yelling, "You got Florida!"
Sergei Bobrovsky, second place all by himself.
Look away, Leafs fans. After sending Toronto home in the second round last season, Sergei Bobrovsky handed the Maple Leafs another loss on Thursday, stopping 29 of the 30 shots he faced. Bob has allowed two goals or fewer in each of his last six starts against Toronto.
The Anaheim Ducks with the number 2 overall pick of this year's draft.
We are proud to select from Orbro SHL, Leo Carlson.
So it's the big Swede.
I'm just going to get right to the scout speak here. Big body, tough along the wall, extends plays, absorbs contact.
A lot of comparisons being made to Nick Backstrom or Kopitar or Matthews. Those are pretty good comparisons as he goes second overall to Anaheim.
Congratulations.
Thank you.
This is a big deal. Welcome to the NHL.
Thanks so much.
Take a picture. Okay, let's go see your team.
This guy is going to be a really good NHL pro. He's going to play for a long time, and as you mentioned, the floor is there. I think we're only going to see better than what we see right now.
And very self-assured and confident young player.
Yes, Yes. Welcome to the National, Leo. On Thursday, Leo Carlson, the second overall pick in the 2023 draft, got his chance to experience what every hockey player dreams of, their NHL debut. After suffering a lower body injury during a preseason practice, Carlson had to wait until game number three before he could suit up for the Ducks for the very first time. But the 18-year-old seemed to fit right in as he centered the top line and quickly showed why he's a key piece to build around in Anaheim.
This is truly a big moment in Anaheim Ducks history as welcome Leo Carlson to the fold. It's going to be an incredible night. I cannot wait to see how this one unfolds.
Tonight against a really good veteran team with the Dallas Stars, he's going to be tested.
Zegras wants a one-timer. Fat rebound score for Troy Terry.
Top line gets things going for the Ducks. And boy, that's going to be a relief for Troy Terry as he bangs home that short rebound. Ottinger can't put the rebound in a good spot, and Troy Terry mops it up and just absolutely roots it.
The Stars really didn't defend all that well in the first period. Jake Ottinger did. They're fortunate to only be down by a goal.
Now a too many men call against Anaheim, and they are protesting it about as much as you can.
Anaheim, bench minor penalty, too many men on the ice.
Well, they get together and talk about it, but the call remains.
And put the Stars on their third power play of the night.
Pavelski feeding in front, hits, he scores! First power play goal for the Stars this year.
Pavelski hints on the cutter, that's eloquent, and it's a tie hockey game in the OC midway through.
Power play number five for the Stars. Haskinen again. Wrist shot, tip, score! Pavelski, second power play goal for the Stars, and Dallas moves in front. The Stars, they've got a 2-1 lead heading to the third.
2-on-1, Terry gets on his horse across the line with Carlson. Carlson, score! First NHL goal for the second overall pick.
This kid is special. He got a beautiful feed. It was the speed of Terry that really got separation. Stick on the ice. He wants that puck. And just like that, this game is all tied. What a moment for Carlson.
How about the atmosphere in this building right now?
Beating Haskinen. Has a lane left side. Dropped it in front. Score! Haskinen's pass. Caromed in. And Miro Haskinen will get credit for the goal. And Dallas jumps back in front. And the Stars hang on. They pick up a 3-2 victory over the Ducks.
You get your first NHL goal in your first NHL game. Your parents were jumping in the stands. You got it right here. You got to show it to the camera for sure. How did it feel?
It felt good. Obviously, the game tying goal there as well. So yeah, it was a lot of hype there. Thought I had a pretty good first period and a horrible second period, actually, and then a good third period. The third period there as well. So yeah, good bounce back. A great support in my whole life. So it's it's an honor there to share that moment with them, sure.
Though the Ducks came away empty-handed on Thursday, Leo Carlson made an impact in his first NHL game, tying the score in the third period with his first career goal. Carlson joined Connor Bedard and Adam Fantilli, who also recorded points in their NHL debuts, becoming the fifth draft class to have the top three picks each record a point in their first NHL game. Kels, I have to imagine, anytime it's your NHL debut, so emotional, but you get your first goal, your parents are there. He was impressive right from the jump of this one. What did you make of Leo Carlson's introduction to the NHL?
I like the word you use, jump. He had a lot of jump in his game in this one. And if you think about Leo Carlson, you think about a guy who protects the puck well, cerebral player. He's going to make his line mates better. He had a lot of pop in this game. Every time I was noticing him as this game went on, it was because he was skating the puck up the ice. He was skating the puck into the offensive zone. He had some good entries that were setting up chances. This was an entry here, a middle lane drive. Another one right here, where he's getting his teammates involved, leading to chances for the Anaheim Ducks. And probably not surprisingly, as this thing goes along, it's not Carlson with the entry, but he's on a odd man rush here, and he receives the pass and scores. So he was involved in the rush a lot, was my main takeaway from this game. Great anticipation there, goes in on a breakaway as well. As far as first games in the National League go, pretty darn good one for Leo Carlson, who finished the game second on the team in controlled zone entries, second on the team in slot shots as well.
Yeah, not bad. He said it would be surreal entering the night and just hoped everything turned out well. Of course, you'd like to get the win, but I think overall a very nice first National Hockey League game. Kels, thanks so much, as always, for all of your insight.
This way, it's Andre Burakovsky. He'll rethink it, shoot it, stepped in! Yanni Gord! The pepper pot on the spot! Seattle off and running! That's Gord's first of the year.
Gord's always been a pest and a thorn in Carolina's side.
Now Slavin with a shot, and they'll score! Carolina with the answer right away! And we're tied at one! The Stahl brothers have now joined the Richards in Montreal, Bobby and Dennis Hall in Chicago, the Stasnys in Quebec, and the Sedin twins in Vancouver. That is some elite company to be in.
Been fortunate enough to play here in Carolina for a long time, and I know Eric probably got to that number a little quicker than I did, but you know, it's obviously a good feeling, and you know, try to keep adding those up, I guess.
Mako shoot, Cassino power play, Schwartz score! Oh, a nifty little dangle out in front by Jaden Schwartz. It's a power play goal. 25 seconds left in the kill. Dunn, a shot kicked out. They score! Shorthanded goal. His first as a Kraken. Pierre Edward Belmar. Jaden Schwartz has a power play goal tonight for Seattle. Dunn with a shot. He scores! Right down Lenny Wilkins' way. A bullet from Vince Dunn on the power play. 4-1, Seattle.
It does look like a goalie change is being made here.
Yordo Kochetkov will take over. So it's 4-1 Seattle, but the other side are the Carolina Hurricanes, and they can come from behind. Now Carolina sending it across. Jarvis, he scores! And there's the quick goal. 1:08 into the third period. Seth Jarvis, and it's a 4-2 game. Nason behind the net. He'll get it to Kotkaniemi. They score! And yes, Barry Kotkaniemi has gotten Carolina within one.
And all of a sudden, it is a 4-3 game. And it is all Carolina right now.
We'll get away from Nason to the slot. They score! Jared McCann! Hey, hey! What do you say? 5-3, Seattle!
You cannot sit back, because you know Carolina is going to start taking even more chances here.
And a penalty will be called. They score! That's a beautiful pass from Matty Beniers. The Kraken by 3.
The last time the Preds took the ice at MSG, they were on the losing end of a 7-0 drubbing. Thursday night, Nashville looked to flip the script against the Blue Shirts. Stick around for more highlights after the break.
Sit back looking for McCann. The follow-up, Barry. A drive and a rebound, score! Cole Smith tumbling into the net right behind the puck.
And watch Smith. He will not be denied. He's going right after that. Takes some contact. That puck goes in. Smith goes into the net. And the Preds up 1-0.
So the Rangers going on the power play. Picked up. Out of the box comes Smith. And he's got it on a breakaway. Ryan O'Reilly behind him. Smith scores! 2 goals in the first period for Cole Smith. And the Predators have doubled the lead.
Cole Smith, are you kidding me? Out of the penalty box, second goal of the game to put the Preds up 2-0 on a breakaway.
Nashville is 0-1 tonight on the power play. High slot O'Reilly. They move it quickly to forward, but right there O'Reilly. Score! Outstanding passing. And Luke Evangelista put it right on the tape for O'Reilly. It's a power play goal, 3-0.
A power play goal, that tic-tac-toe right there. O'Reilly started that off after the feed from Barry and then finishes off just an absolutely gorgeous passing play.
Panarin tried to get it to Miller. Smith broke it up. Here's a breakaway chance. Parson and moves in. And a save by Shesterkin. Oh, man. Big save by Igor Shesterkin.
Forsberg drives through one wave of blue jerseys. Forsberg scores! Philip Forsberg pulls out the slap shot. And he rifles it past Shesterkin. The second power play goal of the night. Forsberg's first of the season on his 24th shot.
You think he's having fun? Did you see that smile?
And Jonathan Quick.
Going to make his Rangers debut.
Yeah. Sometimes a goaltending change will spur your team. And so the Rangers with a 5-on-3.
Fox. In the looks like it'll be Fox's goal. It deflected off the defenseman. And the Rangers are on the board.
Yeah, Fox is trying to make the pass. And it hit Ryan McDonough. And so the Rangers get back within three.
So time ticks down. Nashville will pick up their second win of the year. And after getting crushed 7-0 in this building last March, UC Soros comes back with a strong performance. And Nashville wins it 4-1.
Hanifin working it through center. Huberto's pass across. Anderson shoots into traffic. Rebound comes free. Huberto scores! Huberto banks it in off the skate of Levi. And the Flames take a 1-0 lead 49 seconds in.
And we're going to see Rasmus Anderson from the point put this on net. Levi has no idea where the puck is. Huberto comes in and banks it off the pad of Levi.
Calaposa back up top. Darlene to the far side. Shots go. First point and first goal as a member of your Buffalo Sabres.
Sharangovich played it in front. Another chance. Dewar scores! Walker Dewar! Fourth line goal. The Flames back on top. 2-1 Calgary.
Power play with 1:27 remaining. Thompson, far circle score!
Of the year, ties it up at two, and the power play can feel better about itself.
This is it right here. Once he had that cut, I knew he was ready to play
flow.
Hockey tonight.
You want
to
go, pretty boy?
It was the
yes.
flow.
Exactly. Yes.
It was the flow. Think the mullet has to. Returned, and so too has his shooting touch.
Final minute of play in the period. Here's a chance now. Between the legs, shot by Petrarca, shut down by Bernard.
That's a great save. Clever save and real good pickup.
He lost to try to make a move. Here's a breakaway chance for Lindholm. Takes the pass. Save by Levi. Not on my watch, Devin Levi says. Not now.
Watch Levi. He keeps his body still, straight, stays. He attacks. He challenges him. And Lindholm's got nowhere to go, and he's able to pick it right off.
Good read by Lindholm. Here's Benson late in the shift. Knocked down on aggressive play by Gilbert. He'll take off. Try to take off with it. Gets away. Four Flames on the line. Gilbert hits the trailer. Here's Cornell on the pass. They score! Beautiful play. Blake Coleman with the finish.
Down the right side. Cousins in the middle of the ice. Scores! J.J. Paterka. Roofson. And we're tied at three.
Dubé in a battle. Knocked down along the boards. Flames get it again. They score! Rosicka! Able to snap it home, and Adam Rosicka puts Calgary back on top in this seesaw battle in Buffalo. Flames steer home a 4-3 win in Buffalo. Six straight victories at KeyBank Center.
Falk will play it across. Going right back it over the line. Opportunity here.
Coming behind the net with a wrap-around.
Oh, and stopped by Ingram as he robs Alexandrov.
Unreal save by Connor Ingram. I thought this was going to be automatic. Automatic wrap in. I thought he had him, but look at the push here by Ingram. Look at the flexibility.
Arizona so far in the power play, 3-for-15.
Back of the line, Valimaki. Here they come again. Michelli across. Bukestad scores! Nick Bukestad! It's a power play goal, and the Coyotes are on the board. You can feel this one coming, and Greg Berube is not happy.
Blues will bring it out. Torpchenko, nowhere to go. Schmaltz on the counter. Here come the Coyotes.
To the front, and a goal! Clayton Keller, and he's done it again in St. Louis. Wow, 2-0 Coyotes. Wow, welcome back home, Clayton Keller. You knew he was going to put something on the board here tonight.
Now Kevin Hayes back in. Shoots it off the glass. That rings around to Scandella. Now right in front. Brauna shoots. He scores! Jacob Brauna with a rocket. And it's 2-1.
That's just what the doctor ordered for the St. Louis Blues.
Sean Durzi trying to advance it. Coyotes will take it away. Here they come. Carcone.
Carcone to the front. He scores! Michael Carcone gets it right back.
And it's 3-1 Coyotes.
That is how you answer right there.
up in front. Kylie's trying to come away with a loose puck. They do. Right to the front. Schmaltz backhander. He scores. Nick Schmaltz, and what a setup. Sean Durzee. 4-1 Coyotes here tonight in St. Louis.
And now, if the Coyotes can score here with the man advantage, this will be the nail in the coffin.
Matias Michelli goes across. Shot and a goal. Jason Zucker. And the Coyotes with a 5-1 lead.
And they are 2-for-2 in the power play. Jacob Braun in front. They score. Sammy Blay on a great feed. And Blay makes it 5-2.
Jacob Braun having himself a pretty good offensive night, all things considered.
Coyotes will go to the power play here. Jersey's got it. He walks right down the middle. He scores. Corner shot by Durzee. And it's 6-2.
Missouri native Clayton Keller was part of the St. Louis Junior Blues program when he was a kid, and he always puts on a show in his hometown. He notched 2 points on Thursday and has 11 goals and 15 assists against the Blues in his career, both his most versus any single opponent. It's time now for your Top Shelf Plays of the Night.
Mikey Acemon, he's in, shoots, scores! Mikey Acemon, top shelf tagging!
That was a clean, pure shot.
Puck comes up the boards to Stenlin. He moves, he fires, he scores! First is a Panther!
And that one just sails over top. Look at the rise of that puck.
Watch out for Barry to break! A yawning net. Perfetti across. Dylan has room. Shot. Zane Thompson. Rebound. What a stop on Perfetti.
Oh, what a save by Logan Thompson. And now the early candidate for the save of the year right there. Marconi. Marconi to the front. He scores.
Completely fearless. And that is what the Coyotes need to see more of from that man who led the entire American Hockey League last year in points.
Time now for the three stars of the night. Our third star goes to Vince Dunn, who led the Kraken in time on ice and recorded his sixth career three-point game in Seattle's 7-4 win over Carolina. Pierre-Luc Dubois earns our second star, finding the back of the net twice in a 12-second span to extend LA's lead, marking the third fastest two-goal scored in Kings franchise history. And our first star is Cam Atkinson, who scored twice in Philly's 4-1 win over Edmonton, his first multi-goal game since March of 2022. That does it for us, for our entire team here at NHL Network. I'm Erica Wachter. Thanks so much for watching, and we'll see you next time right here on The Fly.